Marawi marks 2 years since it was freed from the hands of the Islamic State-inspired Mauthi militants. The rebuilding is underway, as the war-torn area has now been cleared of debris. Our correspondent Roxanne Arevalo now joins us on the line for an update. Roxanne, go ahead.
Carmina, wreaths and flowers were laid before the memorial wall inside 103rd Brigade, where names of the soldiers who sacrificed for the liberation of Marawi were etched. Gun salutes were also given in their honor. This highlighted the commemoration of the Marawi Liberation Day. OPAP Secretary Cardito Galvez said these soldiers should not be forgotten as they have been instrumental in the liberation. Galvez, with HUDC Secretary Eduardo de Rosario, also attended the peace forum where they got to converse with the internally displaced persons and announced to them that the debris and UXO clearing had just been finished and vertical development in the most affected area would start soon. De Rosario said that by November, they would start bringing in equipment in the MAA, and the $13 billion construction of road networks and installation facilities would follow, most likely by December or January next year. This despite hundreds of ruins were still in the area, as homeowners did not consent to the demolition of their damaged homes. De Rosario said bombs could still be inside these homes and cannot be removed and recovered until these homes are brought down. De Rosario said they would have to discuss this matter again with the LGU and decide how to go about it. Roxanne Arevalo, ABS-CBN News. Thanks. We'll be right back.